These kids, growing up in slums for cities, know nothing of this country, but are too familiar with red, that white and blue as they pledge an allegiance to malfeasance, the hues of Crips and Pirus, gang banging survival tactics for kids who drop out of high school. 21st century NWA, where hearts colder than ice cubes. Where there's no doctor for Andre. Bullet wounds heal in tombs, 6 feet deep. The hood is a perpetual cocoon and there are no butterflies to flap their wings. There are no butterflies, there are only tattooed butterflies and RIP signs on the girlfriends of those slain. The queens of Latin kings. The mothers who have shed enough tears to form moats in front of their homes. Amidst the excitement, wondering, and pediatric pondering, never does a mother dream of her newborn becoming a child soldier. The 10 fingers she counted were not made for gripping 8Ks and blasting 9s until gun smoke eclipses the sun's glory from Brooklyn to Uganda and hopes capped with a little light in the hearts of troubled youth. Kids have nothing to do with war or the stubborn hubris of men who have forgotten that they're still lower than the angels and that a God complex simply speaks of how fragile that the mind can be. The triple OG on the block will die unable to pronounce the words of his own obituary, yet still, as young David, skipping class to sling rocks. If we can't afford shares, why don't we invest in our youth and increase our livestock? These project high-rises on Goliath, so despite the height of adversity, there's nothing that can stop the blessing that will fall from the heavens, these kids. Growing up in slums for cities just need a little bit of hope. They need to be told that they are precious, that their thoughts are divine jewels that can glisten anywhere in the world, to be reminded to wear them well, so that when the innocence of the day is abducted by the darkness of the night, they'll remember to shine rather than fight. Yeah. Yeah.